What is global warming? Global warming is the observed increase in the average temperature since the mid-20th century of the atmosphere at the Earth's surface and oceans and project warming into the future.
What is the effect of global warming? Global warming is caused by the release of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, carbon dioxide and methane. Greenhouse gases prevent to escape in infrared radiation from Earth to space, causing the heating of planet Earth. Heat, instead of finding its ways out into space, is caught in the atmosphere as if it were caught under a thick blanket, causing an increase in temperature.
How it affects animals and nature. One of the effects of global warming is the melting of glaciers on Greenland and Antarctica. This will lead to a sea level rise, flooding low-lying areas such as river deltas and making most coastal areas vulnerable and to storm surges and high tide. The Arctic melt going on today is also related to the health of animal species that live in these frozen climates. As global warming takes hold, natural ecosystems will continue to change, leading to the annihilation of many species. Currently, the most at risk is the polar bear, which depends on the Arctic sea floes to hunt. Another area at risk of dying due to global warming is the plethora of plants and animals living in the Amazon rainforest. Global warming is expected to add to the problem of deforestation, leading to these ecosystems, which are normally protected by a thick canopy, to become savanna. How it will ruin the economy?
Even today, huge losses in industry and the economy are being felt across the subtropical areas, around 30 degrees north and south of the equator, where descending dry air is causing the evaporation of water from farmland and broadening the deserts at these latitudes.
Over the past 30 years, areas covering about 1 degree of latitude around both the northern and southern hemispheres have turned into desert. Just 30 years ago, the cultivation of plants and agriculture were possible in these regions, but not anymore. Future, the drying out in these regions is leading to a decline in freshwater for human consumption. On food and water security is causing social and political conflict across these regions, which further exacerbates famine and food shortages. Another disaster effect of a warming climate is the rise in temperature of the ocean. The temperature of the ocean determines the size and intensity of tropical cyclones, also known as hurricanes. The hurricane is a type of natural disaster that destroys everything in its path.
What are the advantages of global warming? One of the advantages of global warming will be the ability to manage areas of the Arctic. Currently, these areas are too desolate and isolated to do so. Another advantage, though not an effect of warming, is the fertilization of plants with CO2. However, with such a huge increase in the number of natural disasters, this advantage will be negligible for an even warming world. We shouldn't prevent these adverse phenomena caused by global warming.
We must decrease carbon dioxide emissions by burning less fossil fuels. This is the simplest manner in limiting the greenhouse effect. In 1992, at the Earth Summit in Rio de Janeiro, 153 states, including Poland, signed a convention to prevent dangerous climate change. This led to an obligation for Poland to monitor its greenhouse gases and increase forestation. In 1998, Poland signed the Kyoto Protocol, which sets binding obligations on industrialized countries to reduce the emissions of greenhouse gases can do to limit CO2 emissions. 1. Reduce the burning of coal. 2. Check the efficiency of electric appliances. 3. Increase the efficiency of internal combustion engines. 4. Improve the thermal insulation of buildings. 5. Use natural gas instead of crude oil for central heating systems. 6. Introduce new technologies for industry. 7. Enrich fuels with hydrogen gas. 8. Reduce the maximum speed limit for cars.
Adhering to these guidelines, it should be possible to reduce emissions by half. Eventually, to avoid dangerous climate change, it will be necessary to stop all anthropogenic CO2 emissions, in other words, get off fossil fuels completely.